बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, अस्सलाम वालेकुम गपशपर्स, वेलकम टू अनदर एपिसोड ऑफ फुटबॉल गपशप। गपशपर्स, इफ़ यू कुड प्लीज़ प्रेस द सब्सक्राइब बटन, इफ़ यू कुड प्लीज़ प्रेस द बेल बटन आइकॉन सो यू कैन रिसीव द न्यू नोटिफिकेशंस, एज वेल एज इफ यू कुड प्लीज़ ऑल्सो प्रेस द लाइक बटन। एंड फ्रेंड्स, इफ़ यू कुड ऑल्सो प्लीज़ शेयर दिस चैनल एज मच एज यू कैन विद योर फैमिली एंड फ्रेंड्स ऑन वेरियस सोशल मीडिया प्लेटफॉर्म्स। सो लेट्स बिगिन टुडेज एपिसोड। As I've mentioned you earlier in my previous episode that I'll be doing the summary of Premier League clubs, of what they have bought in the summer window and who have they sold from the clubs. So in that regard, I'll be doing the second episode in which I'll be discussing five Premier League teams, starting with Crystal Palace, Everton, Fulham, Leeds United and Leicester City. So, starting with today's episode, I'll be beginning with Crystal Palace. As you do know, Crystal Palace is a pretty good team. They have pretty good players, but they do not they always fall short in terms of performance by the end of the season. So this time around, they haven't spent that much due to the reason of financial impact of COVID-19. But anyhow, we'll be going through them and we'll see who have they bought and who haven't they bought. So for the first name, it's Eze, who has been bought for 17.8 million euros. And the next name is Nathan Ferguson, who has been bought as a free transfer. And Michy Batshuayi, who has been signed on loan from Chelsea. Moving on, what we do know about that Crystal Palace has also done a sale. Alex Sorloth has been sold for 20 million euros, as well as Jaroslaw Sorloth, who has been apparently sold on free transfer as well. So Crystal Palace have been doing business and they haven't done that much. Moving on to Everton, they have been pretty successful in the summer transfer window. If I would give an honest opinion, I think they've done the best business. And right now they're performing very good under Ancelotti, and it seems that Everton have done the trick by getting good players and like spending pretty good money on them, and they are getting better and better, and I'm sure that they will get better in coming transfer windows as well. So we'll begin with the names of who Everton have gotten first, starting with, for the first name, I'll be telling you about Godfrey, who has been bought from Norwich. He's a centre-back and he's been bought for 27.5 million euros. It seems like a good purchase. The next name is Allen, who has been bought from Napoli, and the price which has he has been bought for is 25 million euros. Next name is also another midfielder, Doucouré. Doucouré has been bought for 22.1 million euros. He's been bought from Watford and he has done pretty well since he has joined Everton. Next name I'll be giving you is of Nkunku, who has been bought for a mere 250,000 euros. He seems to be a young purchase, but he'll do good. And the best purchase that Everton have made is James Rodriguez. James Rodriguez has really turned his kind of career while he's playing for Everton. He scored some goals, he's made some goals, and he's doing pretty well in Everton colours. So it seems that Ancelotti has gotten himself a hit in this transfer market with James Rodriguez. And another name which they have gotten is Robin Olsen on loan from Roma. He's a backup goalkeeper to Pickford. Now moving on to what Everton have done in terms of outgoing. They've managed to get rid of Morgan Schneiderlin for 2.23 million euros to Nice. They've also managed to get rid of Kieran Dowell for 2.2 million euros. They've also managed to get rid of Sandro Ramirez on free transfer. And they've also managed to get rid of Lou Garbutt, who's joined Blackpool as a free agent. They've also managed to get other big names as well, such as Sklettenberg. Sklettenberg has joined Ajax as a free agent as well. They've also managed to get rid of Keane. He's gone to PSG on loan, and it seems another big name who has left Everton is Theo Walcott, who has joined Southampton on a free transfer. So it seems that Everton have done pretty good job in transfer window. Now we'll be moving on to our next club, which is Fulham. Fulham have bought so many players that it seems that they've almost bought a first 11, or you could say a second 11. Starting with the first name, we'll be talking about Knockaert, who's been bought for 11.7 million euros. And the second name which will be coming on your screen is Harrison Reed. He's been bought for 6.5 million euros. The next name is Kenny Tate. Kenny Tate has been bought for 3.2 million euros. The next person who they've bought is Ola Aina for 2.5 million euros. And they have been pretty busy by getting so many names that they've also bought Lemina, who was linked to United, and they've bought him from Southampton for 2.2 million euros. They've also managed to get Robinson for 2.1 million euros. They've also managed to get Lookman for about 2 million euros. They've also managed to get Tosin. He plays for City Academy and he has joined Fulham now for about 1.65 million euros. They've also managed to get Anderson. He has been bought for about 1 million euros. They've also managed to get Robin Loftus-Cheek on loan from Chelsea, and he apparently completed the deal on the deadline day. They've also managed to get Areola from PSG, and it seems that Fulham have almost got like 11 players in transfer window. Seems a pretty huge risk, but they wanted to change some of the personnel and they've managed to do so. In the meantime, they've also gotten rid of Torre on free transfer. Apparently he has left as a free agent. Fulham have also let go of Magnus Norman. Magnus Norman has also left Fulham on free transfer. He's left as a free agent as well. And moving on, they've also gotten rid of Cesenio's brother. And apparently they've also managed to get rid of so many players that it seems that they couldn't they wanted to change the whole personnel while playing in Premier League. So moving on to Leeds United, we all know that Marco Bielsa has done such a pretty good job that Leeds United seem to be playing a most wonderful football, and they managed to get some pretty good players such as Rodrigo for 30 million euros. They've also managed to get hold of Llorente, who has been bought for 20 million euros. And they've also managed to get hold of Rafinha, who played for Rennes, and he has been bought for around 18 million euros. They've also managed to get another winger, Costa, from Wolves, and he's been bought for 17.7 million euros. They've also managed to get Cock for about 13 million euros. They've also managed to get Mieslier for 6.5 million euros as well. They've also managed to get hold of Joe Gelhardt for about 1 million euros. They've also tried to buy Jack Harrison, but they finally got him on loan from City. So it seems that Leeds United have recruited pretty well. As for the personnel who have left Leeds United are De Bock. Apparently De Bock has left Leeds United, and as well as they've also managed to get rid of Jordan Stevens, who has also left Leeds United. Now we'll be moving on to our last club, Leicester City. Apparently Leicester City has they have done a few business, but they've done pretty good deals, such as they've bought spent their budget on Wesley Fofana, who has been bought for 35 million euros, as well as they've also spent money on Castagne, for he's been bought from Atalanta. He has been bought for about 24 million euros as well, and it seems Leicester City have recruited pretty good. They've also managed to get Cengiz Under from Roma. He's been bought on loan. And as far as to do with the outgoings of Leicester City, They've managed to get rid of Chilwell. They've done pretty good business on him. They apparently got 50.2 million euros from Chelsea. They've also managed to get rid of Hosseini Diabiti. He's joined Rizpor for about 1.57 million euros. They've also managed to sell apparently Adrian Silva, and he has left the club as well. They've also managed to sell Kapuska, who has apparently left Leicester City. They've also managed to apparently let go Rashid Ghazal, and he has joined Besiktas. So friends, that's all what I have for today. Thank you very much for watching Football Gupshup. If you could please subscribe to this channel, if you could please press the like button, if you want to put in a comment for any kind of changes, if you want any suggestions, if you want to give, you can give as well. Friends, if you could please share this channel as much as you can with your family and friends, and if you can please share it on your social media platforms, it will be really helpful. So thank you very much for watching Football Gupshup, and see you in the next episode.